हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल। दिस इज़ द टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ जनरल साइंस स्टैंडर्ड 8। नाउअडेज ड्यू टू कोरोना वायरस COVID-19, द सिलेबस ऑफ दिस टेक्स्ट बुक हैज़ बीन डिडक्टेड बाय 25%। वी विल डिस्कस दिस डिडक्शन or deduced part during the explanation of the topics. So here we are. Students, there are 19 total topics or contents concluded in this textbook of 8th standard, in which we are going to learn the first topic, living world and classification of microbes. Students, there are lots of living things on this earth. On the earth, we found two types of living things. These are plants and animals. There is variety of living world we found on the earth. In this topic, we are going to learn about the living world and also the classification of microbes. Nowadays, COVID-19 is also such a microorganism, but that of microorganism we are not going to learn. Here are some questions given here in front of the topic, which are useful to recall. So look at the first question. The question is, what is the hierarchy for classification of living organisms? That means, which are the hierarchies, or what are the hierarchical classification meaning? Yes, students, we have learned this question and topic in the 7th standard. Hierarchy here means by which the similarities and differences of the classification on which the basic the living organisms are classified according to their similarities and differences both. The second question is, who invented binomial system of nomenclature? The same question has been repeated here. The question is, who invented binomial nomenclature or binomial system of nomenclature? The answer, we all know, the father of nomenclature. Yes, Carolus Linnaeus is the answer of this question. Third question is, which levels of hierarchy are considered while writing the name in binomial nomenclature? Yes, students, we have also learned this same question in the 7th standard. You have to do it by yourself, as we have to consider the today's topic, biodiversity and need of classification. Students, last year we learned that all the living organisms on earth have adapted according to the geographic regions, food ingestion, defense, etc. While adapting, many differences are observed in the organisms of same species too. There are different regions on the earth, and according to the different regions, the organism also have adapted according to the geographical regions. So in this passage, that is included, according to 2011 census, around 87 million species of living organisms are found on the earth, including land and sea. To study such a vast number, it was essential to divide them into groups. See, students, there are a variety of organisms in which we have to study all the organisms, but it is so vast, so how can we study them? Yes, we can study them according to or by classifying all the organisms into variety of categories. This process of dividing living organisms into groups and subgroups is called biological classification. Yes, students, here is the definition given here. The definition of biological classification is given here. We have to learn this definition by heart. Okay, so let's study